For a while now, we've been hearing a lot about June 15th. June 15th was the date that everything was going to change in Disneyland, because that is the date that the state is proposing that they're going to lift the color-coded tier restrictions, the restrictions that we've all been living under for just about a year now. And in doing so, it would then eliminate some of the safety restrictions, the kind of restrictions that would make it difficult to operate a theme park efficiently. But it's been unclear just what June 15th means in terms of, you know, which restrictions or which types of businesses, or even if it's going to happen at all. It hasn't been confirmed as of yet. But we did hear from the state today, and it does sound like they are confirming that June 15th is a thing that's going to happen. And they've also given us details on what restrictions might be lifted, or, you know, what may happen on June 15th. We'll cover capacity limits, social distancing, proof of vaccination, and out-of-state visitors, and more for each of those topics. And we'll start with capacity limits. There aren't going to be any. There will be no capacity limits at all. And that's across the state for all businesses. We're talking bars, restaurants, grocery stores, concert venues, and yes, Disneyland, theme parks. Now, I should note here that this has been the case for a while now in Florida, at least at the state level. And yet Disney has been operating not at 35 or 25%, but they have been operating under capacity limits. It's only just been until recently, the last week or two, that they've really started to escalate those limits up to something that approaches normal levels. So, you know, this doesn't necessarily mean June 15th we're going to get, you know, released wide open at Disneyland. Though, if you've been paying attention recently, it sure does seem like they are trying hard to increase those limits. They have been releasing a ton of new reservations, a couple times, three times at least, maybe four, that they dropped a bunch of reservations. They dropped a bunch and you could get a reservation for the next day, which was wild. So I feel like they're not going as slow maybe as they did at Disney World, but they're still not going to go wide open. Next is social distancing, and again, there will be none. No social distancing required, at least in terms of requirements from the state. They said, you know, as part of this discussion in the details, that, you know, all counties, all businesses are going to be allowed to set their own standards. They can set their own standards aside from what the state is requiring, and that could very well be the case at Disneyland as well. Again, if you look at Walt Disney World, they've only just recently reduced. Or I don't think have they even done it yet? I think they've been talking about doing it, reducing it from 6 feet to 3 feet. And that, the social distancing limits, are really, that's the big thing in terms of what's keeping theme parks from operating what would be considered normally. you cannot be efficient with social distancing. It limits the number of people you can put on a ride, and it limits the number of people that you can have in a queue. It lengthens the queue a great deal, to the point where I heard today, that there were some rides that they stopped letting people get in line. You couldn't even get in the line because they had no place to put the people. And this is a result of increasing capacity without increasing the capacity in a ride or in a restaurant. This is going to be a tough couple of weeks, a tough 3 weeks or whatever we've got left, less than 4 weeks until June 15th. Something to stay tuned to. Okay, next, what about proof of vaccination? And this is where things might get a little difficult. Per the state, proof of vaccination or even a negative COVID test will not be required to do anything, even going to a theme park, going to Disneyland. Sounds great. What's the difficulty, you might be asking? Well, the difficulty is what they said after that. There is a however. However, the state is leaving in some recommendations for mega events. And a mega event is any outdoor live event where there are 10,000 or more people, which sounds a lot like every single day at Disneyland. And the recommendation is to have a vaccination verification process in place. That's the recommendation. And if you're not able to verify that you're vaccinated, or if you haven't been vaccinated, then you would be required to wear a mask. You could still go in, but you'd have to wear a mask. And I can already feel it coming in. All the questions that are gonna be asked: how do you do this? How do you do that? What's to prevent them from taking off the mask when they go in, et cetera, et cetera? Do they have to wear the, anyway, I can already hear all of that. It sounds impossible to manage. It sounds impossible to handle at the gate or inside the park. However, they've already been doing this apparently at the Staples Center where the Lakers play. They've already been doing this at Dodger Stadium and other sports venues. If I understand correctly, the Staples Center, Los Angeles Lakers, It's 100% proof of vaccination or you can't come in. Meanwhile, the Dodgers have sections in the park for vaccinated folks, people who've been able to prove that they're vaccinated anyway, and then for non-vaccinated folk or folk who don't want to prove that they've been vaccinated, and those guests have to wear a mask. Sounds really impossible to manage from what I'm accustomed to at Disneyland, what I'm used to hearing from guests about all the things that they're not willing to do or whatever. But it's strange because this has been happening for a little while now at Dodger Stadium and at the Staples Center, and I have not heard a single thing. I heard complaining the day they made the announcement. I remember that. I remember them saying, you know, that this was going to be a problem or whatever, or people were objecting on Twitter. But I haven't heard anything since then, not since the initial announcement. It's possible, at least, it's possible that it can be done. The question is that a conversation that Disney is willing to have at the gate or in the park? Is that something that they want to get into? I feel like it's different. I feel like it's different at a Laker game than it is at Disneyland. There's a whole different mindset when you go to a sporting event as opposed to when you go to Disneyland. People feel more entitled at Disneyland for some reason. That's just been my experience, my feeling. And I'm sure some of you at least will back me up on that. but there you go. So I feel like it's least possible. But what do I think will happen? Well, they are calling it a recommendation. It's not a requirement. It's a recommendation. So it's not as though they have to do it. This is a choice that the Staples Center has made. It's a choice that Dodger Stadium has made. And it's a choice that Disney can make. And I feel like they're not going to do that. I feel like Disney is not going to require you to evidence your vaccination. That's a guess based on just my own observations. And I feel like I need to say for legal purposes at this point that this is not a fact. And I am simply guessing, and do not take this statement as confirmation of anything at all. It's just a feeling that I have. Disney does not want to verify your vaccination records, but they do want you to come to Disneyland. Okay, and this segues nicely into the last item, which is out-of-state visitors. Another conversation that I don't think Disney wants to have, and that is, you know, can you prove if you're a California resident or not? Well, on June 15th, that all gets lifted. Out-of-state visitors will be fully welcome into the state 100% across all venues, across all businesses. And this is one thing that I do think that Disney will take into effect immediately. On June 15th, they will start allowing out-of-state guests. And I say this because I've heard a Disney spokesperson say it. They haven't said anything publicly. There's been no formal or official statement from a Disney, you know, publicity person or anything like that. It's just something that I heard somebody say during one of those Zoom calls when they first announced that the park was reopening and they were talking about different things. And the guy said, should the state lift the color-coded tier system, that Disney would start allowing out-of-state guests. So considering all that, in some ways, I don't think it couldn't be simpler. June 15th, ta-da, everything is open. Everything. Everything is wide open, no restrictions at all. Except for the recommendation thing, which gets a little bit more muddy when you start talking about what, you know, businesses being able to do some things and not do some things, or they can make their own decisions. That gets a little muddy, but there's at least the chance, there is the allowance for everything to be completely wide open, which makes things very simple. So what will Disney do? What will they choose? And this, my prediction is, you know, based on what I've seen them do at Walt Disney World, is a gradual reduction in restrictions and a gradual increase in capacity, just like they've been doing at Walt Disney World for the past year or so. And that will include out-of-state visitors, and it will not include having to show proof of vaccination. All of this starting on June 15th. Let the countdown begin. But what are your thoughts, Fresh Break? It feels like that date, June 15th, is 100 years from now. I don't even know how we're going to make it to June 15th, especially considering the state of the parks now. I cannot wait to show you guys what the parks look like. I'm going to the parks tomorrow. I can't wait to show you what the parks look like. I'm hearing horror stories of what it's like. I'm still going to have a great time because I love being at Disneyland, and the aesthetic of it is all that I need. But it's difficult to get in rides. It's difficult to eat, that kind of thing. And I'm looking forward to being able to show what that's like. But I'm not looking forward to it getting, you know, progressively worse, possibly, over the next 4 weeks as Disney has been ramping up capacity. While they're not ramping up capacity in rides or restaurants, at least not yet. But we'll see. If you have any questions, let us know in the comments below. We'll try to answer as many of those as we can. Otherwise, thanks for watching, guys. Follow us on Instagram at _FreshBaked and on Twitter at FreshBakedDisney. That's fresh with no E. And we're also on the TikTok at FreshBakedDisney. So until next time, thanks again, everybody, for watching. We love you guys very much. Be safe out there. Be kind to one another. And Fresh Baked. Ha!